tables turn. You can fold or you can stand firm. I'm a real one, so I ain't concerned. I'm fully built for this life. I think I earned all my stripes. I don't believe all the hype. Get back on my feet and get right. Watch you work, watch him hate, watch him lurk. Can't relate, watch you skirt. Out the mud, out the dirt, above the waters, in the murks, out the gate, on sight. Red breed, red tight, set the bar, take flight.
While much of the country is struggling under cold temps and some of that white stuff, no such troubles here at Hard Rock Stadium in Miami. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Pittsburgh Steelers and the Miami Dolphins.
Chris Boswell to kick off for Pittsburgh.
It's the final 3 weeks of the season, Stu. We're underway in week 15. Fielded near the back of the end zone, and they will elect to not bring this one out as our first drive will begin at the 25. From the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of four.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. Wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
Second and six, just inside the 30. Tua gonna throw into a double team, and it's intercepted. The safety, Terrell Edmonds, picks it. And he brings this one back. It's a pick six for a Steeler touchdown.
On for the point after.
And the defense could not have written a much better script than that. First drive, pick six.
The offense never got a chance to really get oiled up there, did they? But the defense, they certainly got in gear. What a big-time play and a great way for them to start.
And now the offense, they've got to turn things around and figure this out because your backs are on the ground real quickly.
Yeah, usually when you're starting the game getting the ball, 0-0 is the only score you're worried about. Now the second time you get it, you're already down a touchdown.
First and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. They'll run on first down. Vinson, and he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down.
22-yard line.
So now they have to contend with second and 13 after the first down run goes backwards. From the gun, it's Tua. He'll get this one complete to Zay Jones. And he'll be upended here after a pickup of three, getting it out to the 25.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion. They would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete. Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
Fielded just inside the 30. That'll go as a 42-yard punt, but a net of 32. They had a 10-yard return, and the Steelers will go on offense here, first and 10. So good field position for the Steelers as they come up first and 10 at the 39-yard line. Looking to throw, Bullard. He's got his man on the crossing route. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. A good pickup there, 26 yards.
Steeler first down.
Anthony McFarland, his first carry of the ball game. And credit the tackle to Derek Barnett. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
To throw on second down, Bullard. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. Give him 14 on that one and a first down. He's a reigning AFC Offensive Player of the Week, and defensively they have to find an answer for him.
And that's what you would do if you were calling plays, right?
Yeah,
you'd
absolutely
make sure that he gets targeted. But the thing about it is the route running. That's what makes him so dangerous, is because no matter what is presented defensively, he runs his route with such skill that he's able to go up and get the football first in each and every situation.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Similar to a shooter in basketball, just connected on the previous shot. They run another set for him on the next play. Now, we had a guy who made the catch. They tried to get the big one downfield, but came up empty.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Throwing again. Bullard. And a flag comes in as that one falls incomplete. Well, let's see who this is on. So the pass incomplete in the end zone, but contact and pass interference.
And now where does the ball get placed?
At the 1 yard line.
1 yard line. They gave up excellent real estate on that one. That's going to look really, really...
And it's intercepted at the goal line. Adrian Amos with a pick. He's at the 50. And the Dolphins are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape, he's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
He'll get the first down and more inside the 20. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. It'll be a pickup of 16 and a Dolphin first down. Now Tua on the bootleg here. Flushed out right. Pass incomplete.
Yeah, that one sailed on him. You've got to make sure you give your receiver a chance to come down inbounds, because they are very gifted. They'll make the circus catches, but they make them out of bounds. That does you no good.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Give right side, Vincent, and they go the wrong way here, knocked back to the 20. 2 yards the loss, and now third and 12.
Sometimes you just sit back and marvel at what he can do defensively. Speed, strength, quickness, he's the whole package, and that package just wrapped up the runner for a loss.
Throwing is Tagovailoa on third down here. It's complete to Parker, left side. And he's going to be stopped well short of what he needed as the tackle is made at the 18-yard line.
Well, we hear so often how tackling has become almost a lost art in the NFL game, but it's so important to tackle well on these receivers, especially in a play like this one. Third down, they gave him the underneath stuff. You got to go and make the tackle right away.
Makes the score.
So they do get 3 points, but that's now three drives with only the 3 points. Not a ratio that's going to win you many ball games.
Not at all, Brandon. And think about it this way. We all know payoff is the key, right? And wouldn't we love to have the concession on every T-shirt that's been printed in football that says finish on it? Because that's the mantra everywhere. Got to be able to finish drives, put points on the board.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only did he say that, but he also told them, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right? The end zone we're trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football and everything else should flow from there.
Quick lesson, never ask the play-by-play guy a question.
Hey, you're my partner. I know you're right there with me.
Throwing on first down, Bullard. He'll find Smith-Schuster. That's complete. And a 6-yard gain gets him right around the 43. A gain of six there on first. I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on. And I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle, and they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. This is Chase Claypool on the receiving end. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. That one goes for 24 yards. First down. On first and 10, Bullard. He's going to go up top for the end zone. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off, Byron Jones. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Intercepted.
First quarter, and now he already has two interceptions.
Yeah, he's got to guard against being tentative from this point forward, though. He's got to still make the right reads, make the proper throws. I've seen guys in this league throw four interceptions in a game and win. He's got to understand, put it behind you, keep pressing forward.
They'll start on the ground. This is Gordon on first down. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down. They had three tight ends in on that set, and they were really good at blocking for their running back.
And give them a lot of credit because in football nowadays, tight ends coming out of college often don't block very often. These guys have really developed into superior blockers, and that's why they use them in this formation so often.
And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. 17 yards for the Dolphins there as they've got themselves a first down. Tagovailoa working out of the gun. Flush to his right. He's going to take off with him. He'll get 3 yards on the scramble there. It's second down.
Now, how about that play? He took a possible negative and turned it into positive yardage and slid down to avoid taking a big shot. Excellent job getting down and avoiding the big hit.
After one, 7-3 the score on EA Sports.
37, Dolphins 3.
second and six. No, scratch that. Second and seven. They'll try the left side. Benson. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. He lost two there, and it's third down.
This defense has really flown around in the first half. They've gotten to the ball carrier before they can really get started. Offense got to come up with something else in order to try and get this running game going.
Out of the gun on third down, here's Tua. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. It's Devin Bush, the linebacker, who picks it. And they will take over possession of the football at their 42-yard line.
At their own 42-yard line.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. To this point, the results have not been good. Two possessions, two turnovers.
And that's obviously something that can't continue, but to go a little bit deeper on that one, I would think about some play calls now, not even necessarily to my best player, but to someone I can trust with the ball. Try and get things settled down a little bit.
43-yard line.
Looking to throw on second down. Bullard. Open man completes it to Smith-Schuster. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. A first down there on a pickup of 25.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Adrian Amos with a pick. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Intercepted. The Dolphins take over first and 10 at their own 17-yard line.
First down Miami as they get set to start the drive.
And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, ah, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line. 11 yards there, first down.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
Take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
Hey, we often talk about defensive end setting the edge, sometimes even the outside linebackers, but how about here? This is a cornerback essentially setting the edge and finishing off that play for a loss.
Second and 11 now. Now they'll throw with Tagovailoa. Going deep here for Parker. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long way out there, but it'll be third down.
As his old brain remembers, when I see five wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
The Dolphins on third down, 0-for-3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This is third and 11. And that is incomplete. The passing game not in sync here early. And now it's fourth down. So it doesn't look like they're going to be able to build off the turnover.
Well, the defense certainly did its part. It got them the football. But you're exactly right. It looks like they're going to have to punt this one away. and it's not a turnover, but doesn't it feel like one after grabbing the momentum with the defensive play?
Yeah, and they had all that momentum after getting the football, and now zapped right back in the other direction.
At their own 33-yard line.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And with three interceptions thrown already, we'll see. Do they rely more on the ground game here?
They may have to change things offensively to try and settle things down, not just for the guy throwing the ball, but for the rest of the offensive unit, because his confidence has to be shaken a little bit. And you just wonder, is the backup going to start to warm up a little bit over on the sideline?
Now a nice throw here, right side. He hauls it in. But he's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down.
Steeler first down.
Back to throw. Bullard. Eluding the pressure right. Bears it out toward the corner of the end zone and nearly picked it off. He had a chance to come down with that in the end zone, but it'll wind up just being incomplete.
That was an interesting look there, because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them, and I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete. When defenses get to the quarterback that quickly, a lot of times it's called a jailbreak. It wasn't quite that fast, but fast enough that he had no time to look downfield and set himself to throw the ball, and as he tried to do that, he was hit and it forced an incompletion.
Third down, Bullard. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked up by Xavier Howard. They are in an interception mood on defense. Had two nice interceptions a week ago. Now two here in the first half.
Yeah, we call it ball hawking. And the only way to truly be good ball hawks is not guessing. It's not just simply anticipation. It's study and understanding what they like to do and beating them to the spot and creating big plays.
Well, they're watching the film, and it's working. They'll run on first down. Benson. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there.
That's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
Here's second and 7 now from the 28. Now a give, right side. Vincent trying to get out wide, but he's going to be tackled right near the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down.
No gain on the play.
Tried to get the edge there. The defense just too quick to the ball.
That's what we call total team defense there. Can't get to the edge, no place to move it inside, and then allows everyone else to run to the ball and create a big time tackle for no gain for the offense.
Here's Tua. Now they go screen. It's complete. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36.
Let's go. Oh, don't be scared. You smell that checkers draw.
A reminder, coming up at halftime, we'll send you up to Orlando. Jonathan Coachman is there, and he'll have stats and scores from a busy Sunday in the NFL. On first down, Vincent. And unable to get downhill there as he'll take this up to about the 37. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it second and 9.
But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped them. Marked that down for a win in the defense's column.
Tagovailoa to throw on second down here. The left side completion to Jones. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
It's a gain of 8.
Creeping up on a minute to play in this first half. On third down, Mixon. And he's got the first down yardage there as he takes it just across midfield. Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number one. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Now a handoff here to his running back. And this time not as successful as he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more.
Down.
Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
Second and 10 at the 49-yard line.
On second down, Tua hit, and the ball is out. And it's picked up by the Steelers. 20, 10. And he takes it back to the house. A fumble recovery for a Steelers score.
Chris Boswell on for the point.
And Charles, look at the big fella. What a rumble that was. Not only to scoop it, but then take it the rest of the way for the touchdown.
And now you know they're going to have to hear about it from now on. The defensive backs, he's going to want to run with them, do their drills, the whole deal. He thinks he's the pace setter now.
It doesn't matter what happens in practice this week, he's smiling. So not much time to work with here. 9 seconds remain in the half as this one is away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards.
At their own 21-yard line.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And they weren't on the sidelines for long, but I'll tell you what, I'm glad you and I weren't down there. We could hear the coaches from all the way up here. They were adamant, you've got to hold on to the football or else we have no hope.
Yeah, it's easy for me to laugh sitting up here, but you're exactly right. If we were down there, that message would have been received a whole different way. Because turnovers, they've been a big problem for them. Got to take care of the football. Got to hold on to it.
So time for the second half as the Steelers have the lead, and they will also be receiving the football here to start the third quarter. Here on first down. Rush coming, and he's taken down. The safety, Adrian Amos, comes crashing in for the sack.
They need to stop to get back into this game, and here's one right to start the third quarter.
Anytime you go into the lockers with that 2-3 score deficit, you're right. You need that stop, get the football back, and they've done just that.
Series to series, play to play.
That huge loss on the sack makes this job much more difficult. It's now second down and 22 yards to go. He'll rifle this one deep right side. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
Well, as we get ready for third down, let's go back and recap here. The sack on the first play of this drive, that threw a wrench in what they were trying to accomplish because they were compelled to throw the ball on second down. A running play was not in the works. And that incompletion set up another passing down here on third and long.
Throwing on third and long, Bullard. And he's going to go down. Back at his own 5-yard line, it's a sack. J.J. Watt make that now 8 sacks for him on the season. Here's J.K. Scott now. And no room for error here as his first punt comes from deep in his own end zone. And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. So it sails out of bounds close to midfield, and they'll say actually right at midfield. They knew they were going to have great field position, went all out, got a little too aggressive.
And you have to understand your angles. They're cut down. When they're that backed up, you've got to be careful going after him.
On first down, Bullard. And he'll be tackled at the 23 after a gain of 3.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Now a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete.
This has certainly been a physical game so far. Limited scoring opportunities for both sides, and there's another chance that goes unfulfilled.
They head to the line facing a 3rd and 7 following the incompletion on second down. Operating from the gun, Bullard. And that will be incomplete.
That's an excellent play by the defender. He diagnosed that one, closed quickly, and helped force the incompletion.
And whistle blown. A timeout here is taken, and it's taken by the kicking team. It's just their first, so 2 remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. And he gets it away. A directional kick going toward the sideline.
The Dolphins take over 1st and 10 at their own 45-yard line.
First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. And Charles, they trail by a couple of scores, but if they could put a good drive together here, it'd go a long way toward getting them back in this football game.
And if you're looking at a checklist of things that they need to do in the second half, job number one was getting a stop, wasn't it? So big check right there. Now they want to see if their offense can build on that momentum.
Here's 2nd and 9, just a yard on that last run. They'll keep it on the ground. Vincent, he'll get 3 up to midfield. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on 3rd down. From midfield, here's Tua. Oh, and Tua going to be intercepted for the 3rd time. Picked off at the 35. And he'll return this one just shy of midfield to the 49. Gosh, you add up last week and this week now. That's 9 interceptions in this 2-game stretch, and we're not done here.
It's almost as if they can't even believe their eyes. Or maybe, partner, is the confidence level in him so high that they believe he'll get out of it and make plays for them to win a game?
Well, they've said they believe in him. That's being tested right here. He'll take a shot for the end zone. And caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Steelers.
Touchdown.
A big play there. Touchdown number 18 on the year. And the Steelers find a way to stretch their lead. And it's 21-3.
It is good. Makes the score Steelers 21, Dolphins 3.
Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And this will be a touchback as Grant opts not to return it.
At their own 25-yard line.
Down. The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. And three interceptions in this game. I would have to think, I wasn't a quarterback, but number four's kind of, oh, you're like, oh, man, I can't throw four.
No, what's interesting is, what do the coaches decide to do now? Having thrown three, do you alter your offensive strategy? Do you take the ball out of his hands and maybe turn to the running game? Or do you have that supreme confidence that he's going to turn things around?
We'll see what they do. They'll keep it on the ground. Vincent, and he'll be upended at the 33 following a gain of three. And guess what? It brings up third down.
Down at the 33-yard line. It's a gain of three. Brings up third and two.
And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. And they give this time to the tailback. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. They're able to convert with a gain of four.
Well, partner, none of these runs individually have added up to a whole lot.
Now, three plays, all three short runs, but together a first down.
Yeah, it's amazing how the narrative changes when you string them together.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Throwing now is Tagovailoa. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
I'm getting the sense that this offense is getting frustrated. Here we are into the third quarter, and they've had plenty of opportunities to get in sync. Thus far, that hasn't happened. They're looking for answers both on the sidelines and in the huddle looking at each other.
55, my guy, 55. My 55, my 55. Hey, eat.
Back to the air on second down, Tagovailoa. And this is going to be caught. He won the fight for the football. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down.
Well, we talk all the time about playing situational football. Right now, I think the scoreboard is dictating what they need to do. Where they are in this game, they've got to push the ball downfield, take their shots, try and get big chunks of yardage in a short amount of time. That was a nice play there.
And he was hit as he threw it there, and it forces it incomplete.
And the passing windows are just not there, and that's just another example of how great this defense has been all game long.
And that's exactly what a top 10 defense can do. They can really change the game tempo and frustrate you as you try to execute offensively.
Third quarter from Miami. This is second and 10.
Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Check nickel, nickel, nickel.
Again, they will throw it with Tagovailoa. Caught on the right side by Jones. And he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. 5 yards. Now it's third and five.
Brings up third and five.
Play number seven now coming up on the drive. Third and five.
Ready? Mike's by four. Mike's by four. Mike
Ultra. Two and a throw again. Throw left side complete. It's Collins. And he is going to have the Dolphins first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. 12 yards there as they keep this drive rolling. It's another first down. And again, it's Tagovailoa. That's complete into the hands of Myers. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line. That's a 12-yard gain now on back-to-back plays. First and goal, Melvin Gordon. He pushes forward for maybe three down to the 6-yard line.
But they certainly have been able to get him going and establish the run, so I think it's time to abandon that plan and start chucking it all over the park. And you know who's excited about that? The defensive front. They got a chance to pin their ears back and get after him now.
Tua wants to throw it on second down. And that is caught. Touchdown, Miami. From 6 yards away. And the Dolphins are able to cut into this lead.
You got to figure down by the goal line. This this is where a tight end earns his money, in the high traffic area. And he's able to work free in the middle of the end zone and grabs that one for a touchdown.
Gold with the extra point, and he makes the score 21-10. After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gold now to kick it away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
5 yard line. The Steelers take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And following that long touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time, see if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen again.
And you would have thought they would have been ready the last time. That's what you work on all the time. Make sure that no one gets behind you. That's the cardinal sin of defense, not giving up the long pass. They did. Let's see how they adjust.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. To throw again, Bullard. And he's going to lose a yard or two. Taken down behind the line. Derek Barnett in there to get him, and that is sack number 6 now for him on the year.
Third and 11.
We're off to the fourth quarter here in week 15. Happy holidays to all. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. The Steelers on third down, 0 for 3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This is third and 11. From the gun, Bullard. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. And he will have a Steelers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. 12 yards that time, and a Pittsburgh first.
First down, Pittsburgh.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Now an option play, and he'll keep it. Only a yard on the keeper, and it'll be second down.
And if you like defensive football, focus on the defensive end on this play. He does everything exactly right. Reads the play, and make sure he spills it for a small gain.
Here's second and 9.
Push him back. He's crashing. He's checking crap.
And he's got it up over the 40 to the 41.
Ball carrier.
A nice play design there with the touch pass. Looked good at the start, but bottom line, the defense was ready.
And they did a nice job scouting, didn't they? Not just scouting, but now executing once they saw the play for real after having worked on it all week in practice. They drilled on the play, then they drilled him.
Throw left side, complete to Smith-Schuster. And he'll be out of bounds up near the 45 at the 44. They get only 4 that time as that leads us to a fourth down.
Fourth down.
And no move to get the offense off the field. They'll stay put on fourth and 1. Operating from the gun. Bullard, he's going to have his running back. It's complete. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A gain of 26 and a conversion there as well on fourth down. Felt compelled to go for it there on fourth down, trailing in the fourth quarter. They got it done.
And there's always a lot of pressure on a fourth down call. Doesn't matter the distance. You still have to get it done, as you noted, and they did.
The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. This will be caught inside the 10. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Again, he'll drop to throw. That's complete right around the 8. And he's in. Touchdown, Steelers.
touchdown.
From 10 yards out. And the Steelers, they broaden their lead. They were still throwing with a comfortable lead here late, and now that lead even more comfortable.
And your first thought is there bad blood that went into this one ahead of time, that maybe they're seeking some revenge or they just don't like them? But the other thing that always hits me is, are they worried about playoff positioning? Right? Are they worried about, do you need enough points in case there's a tiebreaker that comes into play later?
And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right. At the 20.
The Dolphins take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
First down Miami as they get set to start the drive.
Well, I think that the folks here had hoped that maybe this home atmosphere would carry their guys to a surprise victory, but it does not appear that that's going to be the case. There's too much to handle on the other side in this one.
And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. That one good for 33 and a first. So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up first and 10. From the gun, it's Tua. It's his running back, Melvin Gordon. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41.
Complete to
6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and four.
Second and four at the Steelers 41.
Tua sets up to pass it. Open man is Myers. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down. A great job there, Charles, just to hold on, absorb that contact. I guess that's the risk you take catching the ball toward the middle of the field.
It is, and if you're going to gain yardage, you're going to have to go there at some point. But how about the read, okay? The eyes of that play, stepping out from the middle of the field and really making a big hit. Did not get...
He's got it. Touchdown, Dolphins. Devontae Parker. His fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Dolphins are able to draw a bit closer. And Charles, the defender, was there. He just didn't get it.
Sometimes these plays turn into basketball in a sense, with two guys going up for the football. Which guy's going to box the other away from it and grab it?
Yeah, I know you hear it a lot, but it's just the will to get it, right?
Oh, without a doubt. The will, as well as some really nice touch on the ball that was thrown.
And some talent, too.
Set to kick off.
After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gould now to kick it away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Steelers take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
And incomplete, a drop there in the middle third of the field. That'll bring up second down.
At the 25-yard line.
Again, Bullard. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete.
And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. 16 yards, a first down.
Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect him to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
And the Dolphins rush gets home. Down he goes. Javon Hargrave able to record his fifth sack of the season. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So the Steelers with the football as we get you reset. And you'd have to figure they're just looking to burn these final 2 minutes away and get out of here with a victory. Throw on second down. Bullard will get this one to McFarland out of the backfield. They get 14 back, but it leads now to a third down.
That's a good bounce back play right there after taking a sack on first down. Didn't quite get it to the marker, but now they're in a much better spot for a third and short yardage call. Through the offensive coordinator, you like looking at that section a heck of a lot better than trying to figure out third and long.
And he will have a Steelers first down by a couple of yards as they're able to convert there on third and one. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Get this one down near the 45-yard line. Bobby McCain here, the one who brings him down.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
And now running right through him. And he's taken down inside the 30. 16 yards, a first down. Starting to look like this drive, it may be the final nail in the coffin.
Well, this is why you work out so hard, right? This is why you spend all that time in the offseason. This is why you have those OTAs and mini camps for these situations, these scenarios, to run someone into the ground and secure a victory.
And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. So this one in the win column for the Pittsburgh Steelers. And you've got to say, CD, it was the defense who had a big part in the W.
Well, without question, when you force 4 turnovers, you get to enjoy the spoils of victory, don't you? It's rare that you force 4 turnovers and lose a ball game. That's almost unheard of. They carried this one home. You talk about celebrating with each other and being in a position where going forward, all you think about is, let's get 5 next time. They're going to be on the hunt.
So for the Steelers, it's a 10th win of the year now as they move to 10-4. And they'll return home next week to take on the Jacksonville Jaguars. Meanwhile, for Miami, the loss might knock them out of playoff contention as they drop to 6-8.